We are tasked with graphing this equation, and the equation is negative 4x plus 3y equals 0. And we're looking at slope-intercept form, so we're going to think about how we can get that equation into slope-intercept form, which is the y equals mx plus b. And the big thing about slope-intercept form is you have to solve for y. So that's what we're going to do first. We're going to write the original equation down and zoom in on that equal sign, because we have to make sure that we get everything. Y has to be by itself on the left side. We want everything else on the right hand side. The least attached item that I see is the negative 4x, so we're going to go with that first. We're going to move that by adding it. You add it to both sides, which marks it off on the left side and adds it over there onto the right hand side. The 3y would come down on the left, and since we're going for mx plus b, I'm going to go ahead and put the 4x first and then just slide that 0 down after. You don't technically need the 0, but since we're just new to this slope-intercept form, I'm keeping it there so we can see what it means later on. So our new equation now is 3y equals 4x plus 0 after we added the 4x. To get y by itself, we need to divide by the 3. So we're going to take that 3 and divide it. I see 3 terms, so we're going to divide it in 3 places. Right there, under the 4x, and under the 0. When you do all the division, the 3's are going to mark out, you're going to get y equals 4 thirds x plus 0, because 0 divided by 3 is 0. So this is our slope-intercept form, and we're going to bring that to the next page. We have the slope-intercept form, now we're just looking to graph it. And the first thing we're going to look at is the y-intercept and plot that. So let's write down our slope-intercept form. The 0, the reason I left that there was that you could see that that's actually the y-intercept. So if it's a 0, that means it crosses the y-axis at 0, 0. So over on the right-hand side, we're going to put a point at 0, 0. Next thing we're going to do is use that slope to map out 2 more points. Let's look at the slope-intercept form again and take the slope off, 4 over 3, both positive numbers, which means starting at the 0, 0 on the graph, we're going to go up 4 and over 3 to place another point. Place that point and then go up from that one, up 4 and to the right 3, and place another point. You can map this out up or down. And we had room to go up both times, so we just did that. The last thing you want to do is go ahead and draw a line through those points. We drew that negative 4x plus 3y equals 0, or in y-intercept form, it's y equals 4 thirds x plus 0, where the y-intercept is 0, 0, which is why we have a point at the origin, and the slope is up 4, right 3.